Hi, my name is Andrei Osachuk. I welcome you to another training on Analysis Workspace in Adobe Analytics. And today I want to share with you a few methods that you may want to use for visualizations of your forecasts. So the scenario is the following. You are somewhere in the middle of your reporting period. In my case, I use the month period, and today is the 21st of September. And I want to understand whether I will reach my KPI or not. I do have my targets, but this is a separate topic that I will not include in this video. But if you have your target, likely it's somewhere in the other platforms, maybe in your local machine, the Excel spreadsheet or Power BI or something else. And you want to understand whether you will achieve your target by the end of the month or not. And in order to do that, you need to prepare a forecasting model. Unfortunately, the forecasting models are not supported in Analysis Workspace, but there is a workaround. You can prepare a very simplistic forecast because it's much better than nothing. And in my case, this is exactly what I did for this exercise. And this gives me some additional information that, for example, now I can understand that if I do not change anything in my tactic for this month, I will achieve likely this KPI, 170 for the KPI that I chosen for this visualization. And I already achieved 67% from the total number, including the forecast. So in other words, I also know that how much I need to work what will be the final result. And why this is important? Because if, for example, my target is 180, I already know that I need to change something because likely I will miss my target. And I don't need to wait until the end of the month and only then act. I can act much faster. I can act in the middle of the month. I also prepared so-called pessimistic and optimistic forecasts just to get a range, because obviously all forecasting models are not ideal, even complex ones, and I need to have a range to better understand what should I expect. And in this case, I can see that if I look at the optimistic forecast, my number will be 176 by the end of the month, but this is again something much lower than my actual target. This is why now I know that I need to really change something, and tomorrow or day after tomorrow I will talk to my colleagues and we will think what we can do. Maybe we will run a new campaign, maybe we will run an optimization platform if we had a hypothesis how to improve the KPI, maybe we will increase the budget for the marketing spend, maybe something else. But the thing is, we already know that we need to change something. And this is very actionable insight from the analysis. This is what I wanted to show you in this video episode. If you're interested to learn how to prepare such visualizations, how to prepare the forecast, you're very welcome to enroll in my Adobe Analytics Analysis Workspace Mastery course. If you already work with forecasts, if you work with targets, I will be happy to hear from you how you work with such exercises, how you import the data, how you analyze the data, what type of visualizations you are working on a regular basis in order to make sure that you will not miss your KPI. This is it for this training. Thank you for watching. Talk to you next time.